Good taste. Thanks. Can I see a lighter?
Sure.
My dad had one just like this.
Did he? It's funny, I've had this one as long as I can remember. So, where is he now?
Gone. I don't even remember what he looks like. Anyway, thanks again for the cigarette.
No worries, Cherie. So what's a girl like you, pretty girl like you, doing alone, sitting at a bar, waiting for some stranger to come in and tell you to put that glass down?
She'll go back to your wife, babe. Ain't she looking for you?
Not at the moment, no. Hell, I don't even have a paper trail following me. Lucky for you, the only woman I'm attached to is God herself.
You believe that God is a woman?
Oh, I have no qualms about it. This earth is divine. As is this whole vast universe. As are you. As are a whole lot of other things on this enigma of a planet. Fresh fog on a dusky morning. Birds chirping in the city's trees. No, there's no doubt in my mind that this world we live in was created by a woman. Only a woman could have birthed something this beautiful.
You must live in some sort of utopian paradise. Because the world I live in is callous and dirty. If you go up the block, there's probably a group of hookers waiting to spill some powder. The world is painful. It's fucking disgusting. And frankly, I don't think that God would be a man or a woman.
No?
No. I don't think that God would be a man, woman, dog, or a fucking cat. Because I don't think that God exists to begin with. What's your name, anyways?
Frank.
Frank. Well, to be frank, God doesn't exist. He, she, they, whatever, are a figment of your imagination. You and anyone else who thinks otherwise are deluded.
Your shells are cracking, my sweet. You want to tell me who broke it? Wouldn't have anything to do with that that fifth drink you're having tonight, would it?
Don't act like you fucking know me, Frank. I don't need another daddy, okay?
Oh, I'm not looking to adopt, baby doll. But, yeah, I do know you, kiddo. I've known a million girls who are identical to you. They come into this bar, and they sit in that chair, and they've all suffered the same wounds on the same wing.
What, are you a regular here?
If I were, don't you think you would have recognized me? You know, that's a terrible habit.
Are you serious? You gave me the cigarettes.
Hey, I only gave you what you would have found and done either way. You know, nobody's holding a gun to your head and telling you to smoke those things. No, that's all you, Vanessa.
I see you're an enabler.
No. No, I'm just a man watching beauty kamikaze itself.
You and all the other men in my life.
So tell me, have you ever been urban exploring?
What the fuck is urban exploring?
Well, I'm sure you must have heard of it. Everybody's talking about it. These kids in San Francisco, they go into these old abandoned buildings to give dinner parties. They call themselves a suicide club. Anyway, the whole deal with this club is you enter these old buildings, right? You get to see the glorious history of what used to be, along with the decrepit present of what still remains. You know, the peeling paint that's leaking lead and asbestos. Broken glass from all the shattered mirrors. I imagine it must be a real good look into the soul of something created that was once beautiful and now it kind of lost and forgotten. It's bitter, yeah, but it's also kind of sweet. And that little hint of sugar on the tongue leaves you with tender taste of yearning. You know, it must be kind of exhilarating to get in there before the frame wears too thin and the building just collapses.
Sounds nice.
You know, Vanessa, you have to believe in something. You gotta believe in something. Maybe not God. Maybe not even the universe.
How'd you know my name was?
Vanessa? Do you want another glass?
What?
Vanessa?
What?
I said, do you want another one?
I'm good, thanks. I'm gonna go home, okay? How much?
$35.
Thanks.
See you tomorrow?
Maybe.
Your frame of two things.